The IGG Betty Kamia has said that the inspectorate has piqued interest in understanding how the inconsistency in the results came about, yet the Bureau was fully funded to conduct the census exercise. Recently, UBA pulled down the main census report from its website, following public outcry over the contradicting figures that wrongly showed the population of Acholi as dropping from 2,131,443 to 1,941,913, while the Bagisu have fallen from 2,390,975 to 2,096,149.
The provisional results, the final results that had where the public had serious issues with them, and we shall definitely get involved in auditing not only the amount received but also the processes that have been.
Speaking to journalists yesterday at the media center in Kampala, Kamia said that this discrepancy have prompted an investigation into the census exercise. In a robust critique of the Administration of Parliament Amendment Bill 2024, the Alliance for National Transformation, ANT, has called for Parliament to reject the legislation. The bill, introduced by Michiana South MP Richard Lumu, seeks to shift the responsibility of electing the leader of opposition from political parties to individual members of Parliament. Mugisha Muntu, a founding president of ANT, highlighted the dangers of creating a second power center, which he said is a recipe for disaster for the country.
If you elect a leader of opposition without the main party that has that leader of opposition in place, you can easily create two power centers. And that's a recipe for disaster for that party. In that regard, what would you be doing? You just simply be weakening a party.
Alice Lasso, the national coordinator for ANT, emphasized the potential ramifications of the bill, warning that it could destabilize the current political landscape and that it should not reach the second reading.
We understand from history that if this bill found its way into second reading and use the parliamentary practices of voting, a law will be imposed on us that is totally not helpful.
The UPC Secretary General Fred Ebil similarly expressed the rejection of the bill, citing the wrong timing since political parties are preparing for 2026 general elections.
We need to prioritize what comes first. And we think the election of 2026 is a priority to us. We think the other things can be addressed administratively.
The Honorable Lumu attempted to come to us after he drafted his bill. And we said no, at the conception of this bill, we should have been part of this.
The debate over the bill continues as lawmakers weigh its potential implications for parliamentary governance in Uganda. Hurricane Milton tore a coast-to-coast path of destruction across the U.S. state of Florida, wiping up a spate of deadly tornadoes that left at least four people dead and millions without power yesterday. Milton made landfall Wednesday night at the Florida Gulf Coast as a major Category 3 storm. Sustained hurricane force winds smashed inland through communities still reeling from Hurricane Helene 2 weeks ago, before roaring off Florida's east coast into the Atlantic. Wind uprooted large trees and ripped apart the roof of the Tampa Bay Rays Tropicana Field Baseball Stadium in St. Petersburg and sent a construction crane falling onto a downtown building nearby.
We have reports that at least 10 individuals have lost their lives as a result of Hurricane Milton.
By morning yesterday, Milton weakened to a Category 1 storm but was still registering powerful winds of up to 140 km per hour, according to the National Hurricane Center. Scientists say extreme rainfall and destructive storms are occurring with greater severity and frequency as temperatures rise due to climate change. As warmer ocean surfaces release more water vapor, they provide more energy for storms as they form.